there's a good chance that you've already used a type alias at one point or another. But did you know that type alias has a hidden feature? Let's consider this simple type alias. We use it to conveniently store the coordinates of a point using a tuple. But notice how the type of the coordinates is hard-coded. If we try to set the coordinates using double rather than int, the code won't build. And that's when this hidden feature of type alias comes into play. Just like a struct or a class, a type alias can also declare generic arguments. And thanks to this generic argument, we can now use our type alias to set the coordinates of a point using either int or double. Even better, we can also add a generic constraint to the generic argument in order to restrict it to numerical types. A really great use case for this feature is when you need to deal with legacy code that implements asynchronous operations using completion handlers. In that situation, you can define a generic type alias that matches the signature of the completion handler, which will allow you to make this legacy code a bit more readable. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed learning this new trick. Don't forget to like and subscribe so that you don't miss the next video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.